should the following board members recuse themselves due to a conflict of interest?
Well, I think that's law. I think that's law if you have a conflict of interest. I do have some concern, and there are some board members that I think have some conflict of interest on our board when it comes to certain subjects, but not all. But it is, it's law. I mean, if you have a known conflict of interest, if you're, I can't quote the law because I'm not a lawyer, but I know there is a law. So yes, I don't think you should vote if you have a conflict of interest. So.
Yeah, I agree with what Chuck said. I mean, there's very, the Michigan, I'm not a lawyer either, but Michigan laws, it's very clear. It is a very painfully delineated list of circumstances where, as a board member, you need to recuse yourself. And there's not really a gray area. So, I mean, of course, any board member needs to follow that to the letter of the law and recuse themselves. Or even if they think there is a potential conflict of interest, they need to bring that up through the proper process and the proper channels, you know, with the board or potentially legal counsel, whatever you need to do to investigate a potential conflict, just so you don't put yourself or the board in any bad circumstances.
Yes, you should recuse yourself, just because if you've got a conflict of interest, now you may be able to bring something more interesting to the table as part of discussion, but then when it comes down to the vote, you know, you need to just say, okay, I've brought my opinion to the table, that's it, but I can't vote on this because, and that's pretty.
I agree with the prior candidate's comments. Conflict of interest is against the law. It's against our policies in the Lance Creuse schools. And you should recuse yourself. And at the time of the abstention, you state why you are abstaining from that vote. And you declare your conflict of interest at that time. So that's very important. And I think it's a problem that we have a little bit going on in our board right now. There's some conflict of interest that's creating some issues.
Absolutely. There should be no question. And if the board member is not sure if there's a conflict of interest, they should present it to the board why they think they may have a conflict of interest and leave it to the board to decide if it's truly a conflict of interest. But absolutely, there should be no questions about it.
Yeah, I agree entirely, and I'm not going to take up a lot of time stating this. Just I want to make sure in the time we have left, we have a chance to talk also about the strategic planning process. And I don't know if there's going to be questions dedicated toward that. So I just want to insert that needs to be a continuing goal of us implementing that. And at last night's board meeting, it slipped off the agenda. I didn't see it mentioned anywhere. So I just want to make sure that while I have a chance to put this in there, that we keep focus on the strategic plan and just don't let that thing while away and waste on the vine there.
Actually, the law clearly defines what a conflict of interest is for a board member. Spouses, relatives, it's all clearly defined. You have to declare your conflict of interest and recuse yourself from the vote. But I think the public also needs to know that it also defines, I can't just say I'm friends with so-and-so who is in the parapro unit, so I need to recuse myself. I can't do that. I'm required to vote on everything else unless there's a conflict of interest, which would be, in my case, my husband is a teacher in the district.
I don't know if everybody knows, our major contractor, teachers union, the majority of the board couldn't vote on it last time. Think of that. The majority of your board members could not vote on the major contract that we have because of law. That's a problem. I had opposed originally a conflict of interest clause within our bylaws. I was wrong. It's seeping into our district. It's, you know, so you can't vote on it. But as you said, the conversation and things and interests do seep into discussion, decisions, and I'm very concerned about how it's affecting our district. So yeah, it is a matter of law.
Again, being an auditor, resounding yes and absolutely to disclose. And under full disclosure, though my wife is not in the union, she works in the district, so I wouldn't have an issue with that. So everybody knows it now, all right? But absolutely yes, because it is important to know where conflicts exist. And it's more important to know when they exist, what they are. And everybody should know that.